Hello there, very good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us today from Bramble Energy is Tom Mason. Great to see you, Tom. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Pleasure. Now, looking forward to hearing more about your company. It's a great story. Started with three people in a garage, and now it's just excelling. And we want to learn about your progress and your dream as well. So let's maybe kickstart with your vision and introduce us to Bramble Energy.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so I mean, first of all, it's worth starting, you know, the purpose of Bramble and what this activity is in. And it really comes down to hydrogen and particularly green hydrogen. So I just wanted to put some perspective on why we're doing this. And so as the world transitions away from powering everything with dinosaurs, we have to use something that's sustainable so that many future generations can power their lives sustainably. The problem with renewable energy is that at some point you need to store it. You know, there is plenty of use cases where you can imagine it on a house where you're powering your day-to-day lives based on solar and wind. But ultimately, we have to deal with how we store that energy and use it seasonally, as an example. And hydrogen is a great way of storing power. And it, when it's stored, it doesn't degrade. It's easily transportable. And to put it into perspective, hydrogen is already a huge industrial process. We use about 70 megatons a year globally of what's called grey hydrogen, which is produced from fossil fuels. It's equivalent of about 2 million elephants, right? So it's a big number. And the principal challenge around transitioning and the problem a lot of people have with hydrogen is that it's called grey hydrogen, derived from fossil fuels, which isn't good. So first of all, we have to create what we call green hydrogen. So that's hydrogen from produced from renewable sources. And that's one of the areas that Bramble is working on, producing the equipment that can produce green hydrogen. So that's hydrogen produced from water, from renewables. So it's a sustainable process. But really, where Bramble was conceived in the two universities, UCL and Imperial College London, was to revolutionize how we design, develop, and manufacture what we call electrochemical devices. So these are ways of producing power that doesn't include explosions. Internal combustion engines is the example, right? Fossil fuels are burned in processes to produce energy. In an electrochemical device, there's no burning. Right. So you end up, it's much more efficient, it's much cleaner, and ultimately can use things like green hydrogen. So it's a fully clean process. And in the two universities, incubated the idea, which was to produce these devices from printed circuit boards, which is what Bramble has been set up to do. You know, so we've been doing it now for just over a decade. It was about 2010 that the idea was conceived. We spun it out from the universities in 2016 as a fully fledged company. We stayed to about three people until our 2020. And as you highlighted earlier, we went back to a garage because COVID disrupted our plans as such. So we came out of a university into a garage. But by mid-2020, we'd raised our first proper institutional funding. And allowed us to grow. Now we've raised £45 million. We're now nearly 60 people, and growing all the time. We should be over 100 by the year end. You know, it's been huge growth in, frankly, the last two or three years.
Okay, so you just said you're now 60 people. You're going up to 100 people by the end of the year, as you say, from three people originally. So what's the plan for the company? Where are you going with all of this?
So we fundamentally have three business streams in Bramble. The first one we call portable. It's really about delivering units to customers that can power off-grid renewable power from hydrogen. So we've developed a product. It's started manufacture already. It's going out to customers starting this month, and we hope to grow it very quickly. Starting in the UK here, we've partnered with BOC to deliver the fuel to customers. And it's really about transitioning people away from using diesel generation to powering with renewable sources and hydrogen in particular. So that's really one of our business streams, and the growth of that will be to distribute those products on an international scale. So starting UK and Ireland first, we need to optimize the product and how we get the products into those customers' hands, but really want to greatly increase the scale of that product. The second business stream we call mobility. So that's about, you know, we're never going to make trucks and buses and stuff. So we need to partner with OEMs and customers in order to develop our technology so that we can deploy them at mobility scales. It's much, much larger scale of products. We're talking, you know, relatively small off-grid units, portable. Here we're talking about planes, trains, and automobiles and everything in between. So much, much larger systems. But of course, that requires a commercial partner in order to make that happen. And that's what we're engaged in right now is building our presence, is maturing relationships we have with customers so that we can deliver those products to market. Much longer scale though, you know, product development cycles for mobility cases tend to be 3 to 7 years, sometimes 2 years for things like aviation as an example. So really, you know, we've got a huge amount of activity going on now to grow our teams to be able to execute commercial programs across different mobility sectors. Then we have a third business stream, which we call platform. And that's really the hydrogen production side, as I mentioned earlier, it's electrolysis. So it's developing electrolysis technology to produce hydrogen from renewable energy. And that is earlier in stage than the other two business streams. It's something that we've only really been able to start doing as we've raised our latest rounds of venture investment. And it's something that over the next year, we will be deploying larger at scale and testing much larger hardware.
Okay, so they're sort of the three elements, if you like, the product itself, mobility, and the platform. Yes. So why do you think investors should be looking at you right now?
This is a sector which isn't going away. You know, in order to transition away from fossil fuels, we need every bit of technology we can lay our hands on because the scale of the challenge is enormous. And what makes our technology and our business different from everybody else that's around the fuel cell and hydrogen sector is how distinctive our business models and our technology is. One of the features of the technology which has made it attractive to the investors we've been able to attract so far is that our investment rate is significantly lower than anybody else in our sector. You know, because our technology is manufactured through a subcontracting route, we never have to build a factory. So, you know, what a lot of hardware firms, they end up struggling because you have to raise hundreds of millions to build factories. Bramble never has to do that. So our core investments are always deployed to build team resources and develop technology, which is exactly where that money needs to be spent. It doesn't, you know, it doesn't go into building factories. And so, you know, we can, you know, raise orders of magnitude less capital to have equivalent of activity to our competitors. And our competitors, you know, are large businesses. They're valued highly and they're growing very quickly. And we are on the same trajectory as they are. So, we're an attractive, you know, low burn business that has the scope to be as competitive as anybody else in our sector.
All right. Okay. And a compelling case. Thank you very much indeed. That's Tom Mason there from Bramble Energy here on Proactive London.